Actually, Dada believes girls can and do lead. We believe that they can fully step into their power and agency. Our duty and calling is to create the spaces with and for African girls. The Wasichana Africa Summit is one such space. Created, centered around, and led by African girls, this summit provides a platform where girl leaders can gather, share their thoughts and hurdles, and develop informed solutions on what matters to them. This year, at the 6th Wasichana Africa Summit, with the support of girl allies and other girl leaders, African girls spoke truth to their experiences with menstrual health, period poverty, and stigma.
Good afternoon, good evening, good morning, depending on where you're tuning in from. As Warindi said, my name is Diana Karugu, an avid girl education champion, and I work here at Akili Dada. We are super, super excited to kick off the 6th Wasichana Africa Summit today, and it's going to be absolutely epic. So first things first, a big shout out to all of you for joining us today, to all the amazing girls, the young women here today who've joined across Africa. You're the heart and soul of this summit, and we're here to celebrate you. Yay!
My name is Latifa. I am from Kenya.
Hello, everyone. My name is Veronica.
My name is Laureen.
My name is Hope.
I'm Lucy from Kenya.
My name is Chantel, and I'm from Kenya. I first got my menses when I was in class 5.
When I first started my first menstrual cycle, I feel that I lacked enough information about periods, and this forced me to rely on the basic information which I had received.
The first time I had my menses was in class 8. I had all the information I needed when I had my period, so I was prepared for it.
The only person I can go and source information about periods from is my older sister.
Mostly my elder sister.
When it comes to how periods affect education and leadership, I can say that it greatly impacts a girl's ability to concentrate in school or participate in extracurricular activities, and this is a great challenge.
I had severe cramps when my periods came, which did affect my education process and leadership skills. I couldn't be as natural as I was because I was in pain most of the time.
I've had some misconceptions about periods in my community, like when a girl had started experiencing her menses, this showed that she was ready for marriage because she was already at her childbearing age.
What I have heard about menses in my community is that people get menses because it's a curse from God.
Girls who face a challenge of maybe experiencing their period out of their knowledge before they even know what it is.
I was just using the pieces, of course, because I myself I could not afford to buy the sanitary pads, so I was just using the pieces of cloth, which was not safe to me.
I feel that parents and guardians can support girls. They can provide the moral support. They can help us feel more comfortable when we're on our menses.
Parents should always be there to love and support their girls no matter what they're going through during their menses.
Menstruation continues to be a life-altering experience for many girls. In many parts of Africa, limited access to menstrual hygiene products and inadequate facilities challenge girls' education and overall well-being. This issue, commonly referred to as period poverty, hinders girls from fully participating in everyday life. Did you know that in Africa, 1 in 10 girls miss school because they don't have access to menstrual products or because there aren't adequate toilets to use at school? Most will miss up to 20% of their school year, and others will drop out of school altogether.
We believe in the power of education to transform lives. But how can we expect our students to excel academically when some of them must miss school because they lack the necessary sanitary products? This is not only an issue of equality, but also one of human dignity.
Furthermore, period stigma, cultural taboos, and misinformation can worsen the situation. For fear of shame, stigma, and harassment, African girls are forced to cope by reducing school attendance and public participation.
There was this myth that, you know, when you're on your periods, don't go out.
Yeah.
Don't interact with boys first because, you know what, you'll get pregnant.
On your period.
Yeah. It was it was the most unsafe days, by the way. And don't let boys know you've started your period.
Yeah.
Because they know.
I don't know by that. I don't know why it was... We were taught to hide our periods.
It is really a big thing because in our school, there were these NGOs which came to distribute pads. And then they would come, all the girls to the dining room.
Yeah.
Please don't tell anyone.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they give you, and then you hide them in your sweaters, in your pockets. And then you go and you sit like this in class. So no boy should know that you're on your periods or you started.
Yeah.
It's really messed up because the boys, even when they would know, they're like, oh, Kumbe, that one is a big one.
Yeah.
And it would really stigmatize you on everything. The music, if you were a performer in music and games, you'd actually be stigmatized from there. And it was really unpleasant experience.
Yeah, how do any of these myths affect adolescent girls?
It affects adolescent girls in such a way that they cannot be free to speak about their experiences. They cannot speak about what they're going through when they're on their menses.
Mm.
For example, someone can be going through period cramps and doesn't know what to do.
Yeah.
You can't advise them because they don't want to talk to you about it because they've learned it's dirty.
Mm.
They shouldn't share. And most men don't know, like, the truth about periods. For example, my brother.
Mm-hmm.
Let me use my brother as an example because I had it from him directly.
Mm.
He thought, like, periods just come at once, like urine. Yeah, so, like, it should be taught to everyone not just women and young girls, but
comprehensively,
everyone, so that people know what girls are going through, how they can help, and just being educated on it.
But African girls continue to prove that they are indeed unstoppable. Across the continent, they are speaking out and formulating innovative solutions to tackle period poverty and period stigma, and calling for accountability on matters of menstrual health.
If you don't like my color.
Hi, my name is Sophie and I'm from Kenya. I'm a member of the Rotary Club of Kitengela and the Public Image Director. Through our signature project, Mwezi na Dada, I've been able to participate in a number of social media campaigns by sharing photos, messages, infographics to just spread awareness and try and reduce menstrual health stigmatization.
As an African girl leader under the Resource Center for Women and Girls, I teach girls from the slums of Nairobi and rural areas such as Samburu how to make reusable sanitary towels.
Also, I've started a club that is the Young Girls for Young Girls Club in my school, and our aims primarily are actively participating in the pad drives and also making timely contributions that are used to facilitate the Shikilia pad drives. Also, we empower each other so as to help in building our social and academic lives with an aim to become women of substance in the near future.
My project goes by the name Safi Amiable Pad Kit, and the kit consists of 4 sanitary towels that can keep the girl going for a maximum of 1 year. We have cleaning detergents, and which the girl gets to use when cleaning their sanitary towel. And because of this, we had to come up with this affordable sanitary towel, which the girl can use and also reuse, because our project is biodegradable, hence it doesn't pollute the environment.
I feel like creating safe spaces for women and girls is really essential, because, I mean, girls and women in the world don't really find like a space where they can freely express themselves, freely be themselves, because of also how society sees women. And I feel like creating these spaces is really essential, because women and girls have conversations in there, we have fun, I mean, we just be ourselves, and that is really important.
But the Wasichana Africa Summit is not just about the talk, it's also about the walk. It's a space for African girl leaders to speak and for girl allies to say, we hear you, we support you, we've got you.
Currently, what Akilidada is doing, there's a menstrual health campaign that we've been running where we are looking to have period banks set up in schools that we work with across the various counties locally here in Kenya. And that is part of ensuring that there's access. Girls have continuous and consistent access to education. Therefore, if for some reason they're not able to go to school because of their menses, especially because of them not getting a product, being able to access menstrual hygiene products, if those products could be available and accessible and restocked as well, I think for the subsequent years, it would be good to see that replicated nationally in every school.
In the next 5 years, I picture a world where I'm just walking and, you know, I don't have to be on my periods, but I'm just walking, I see a menstrual bank somewhere. I can just go and pick a menstrual product somewhere. I dream of a world where, you know, there are no taxes on menstrual products. When they can't access menstrual products, it really limits their opportunities, it really limits their potential. And I feel like, you know, these things should be given for free. And also, if they're given for free, what's the quality that, you know, they need to be of good quality. And to be honest, organic sanitary towels are really expensive, let's be honest. And I feel like it's really unfair, because that's the good quality and many women and girls cannot really afford or access them easily. So access to these products will be really, 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 really essential.
There is a lot that is that we're doing to eradicate periodic poverty and also fight stigma around periods. And one of the things is to build confidence and be period proud. And another thing is to raise awareness among girls that are in rural areas to ensure that they know what's going on in their bodies, they know how to handle it, the situation, and also be able to talk about it and eradicate the myths around menstrual periods.
As an organization, we are currently working to advocate for the removal of tax on sanitary pads, because we believe once this tax is actually removed on these sanitary pads, all girls in Tanzania will be able to access freely, and if not freely, at affordable price, the products that are important to maintain their menses with dignity. But we also advocate for facilities in school, access to water, and really addressing issues like walking long distance to school, because we know all of this increases the stigma, increases the problems that girls face when they are going through their very normal monthly period. In Tanzania, girls miss 4 to 5 days every month because of challenges associated with menstrual health and hygiene.
At Akilidada, we strive to end period poverty by making sure that all our programs are gender inclusive. So we do this by conducting pads drives. We visit schools in informal settlements, children's homes, and prisons. During our pads drives, we donate sanitary products and we conduct mentorship sessions In these mentorship sessions, we seek to desensitize stigma around menstrual health.
So at school, we encourage girls to speak out. And girls out there, it's important that you speak out against stigmatization of girls who are under menstruation.
Nous avons dédié un module complet sur la santé sexuelle et reproductive grâce auquel nous renforçons la confiance en soi de nos participants. Nous leur donnons des leçons sur l'hygiène menstruelle et nous les outillons sur comment elles peuvent réagir ou faire face à des situations de stigmatisation ou de violence psychologique.
We have established partnerships with local NGOs and community organizations to provide free sanitary products to our students in need. We have also implemented comprehensive menstrual health education programs to empower our girls with knowledge and to debunk the myths and taboos surrounding menstruation.
In Ladies Gen Forum, we champion menstrual hygiene and talk against menstrual poverty by call for donation from the community on the to donate for sanitary pads so that we can donate them to the families and girls who are coming from marginalized groups. But we also educate, create awareness to the community, to men and boys, women and girls, on how to harness the menstrual so that it can be not a curse but a privilege and honor to girls, so that they can feel proud that they are actually getting into the cycles of menstruation.
I do advise young girls is irrespective of where you are, it is important to just find out from your community, from older girls, from your parents where possible, where is that you can access these facilities. Yeah, so I know there are certain bodies that actually do give free pads, or, you know, just find out in your neighborhood who are those. And it would be good to go to them even before your periods come, as long as you're in that age group that I've mentioned, from the age of about 10 years to 16 years. It would be good to start, you know, just understanding where you can get the help from. And yes, we can prepare for it, as I've said, and we can help and hold other girls' hands, you know, as we move along in this journey. So remember your sister, remember your colleague, remember your younger friend, or, you know, and help and impact knowledge where you can, impact your experiences and see how you can help another person not to go through either the same trouble you went through, or to have a smooth experience as you could have when you went through it. Yeah,
I remember just having so many questions and being so afraid of asking the teacher or asking my mom or asking my grandma. So I ended up just asking other girls in class about what their experience was. And that's where I actually really, really learned about periods. I actually learned from my schoolmates. And I think also on the Brave video, something that I have noticed is that some girls spoke about their older sisters being their first point of information around periods. So I just wanted to point out that sisterhood is really, really great, because we've become resource, I mean, sort of older sisters have become resource persons to their younger sisters. And I think to just ensure that everyone has adequate menstrual health information, that schools or maybe, yeah, especially schools and parents should give comprehensive menstrual health information to their girls. What do you think, Zawede?
I feel like when you're on your period, you're most powerful.
I think so too.
Be your sister's keeper. Don't laugh at your sister when she has stained her dress or skirt or trouser because of menstruation. Support her, protect her, be your sister's wrapper.
Although much progress has been made, we still have a long way to go. So this is a call to action for everyone to find ways of supporting girls and supporting us in our quest to end period poverty.
It's a space for girl leaders to celebrate each other and reaffirm their solidarity and to say, no more limits, period.
And for the girls who are out there, despite the environmental factors that are bringing you down to your success. Just forge ahead, focus, and it shall be well with you. With collaboration with Akili Dada, it's time to say, no limit,
peace. I'm black and that's my power. I got it from my mama. Yeah, yeah, yeah. My name is Africa. I am the future and there's nowhere better.
Incredible that the summit went the way it did. Thank you so much to everybody. Just to let you know, even as Akili Dada, as we are hosting, it should not have been possible without your participation. And importantly, we have a team behind us. Girl allies, we could call them, people who are passionate. And we want to say we see you, we appreciate you. Thank you so much for trusting us in this work. We are honored, we are humbled, and we are happy to partner with you to ensure that girls are taking up space, girls are leading, girls are at the heart of following their passions and dreams with full capacity to step into any role they wish for.